We were always told that Ilium is one of the safest places in the galaxy, until you fell off the grid. Sign the wrong contract, join up with the wrong company, or walk down the wrong alley, and it's as dangerous as anywhere else.
Mm-hmm.
Don't let this place fool you. It's no safer here than Omega.
25.
Very few Quarians ever set foot here. Ilium doesn't allow the flotilla to...
Are you shorting prefabs?
Why is that? I want to know why this freaking idiot just interrupted me. Whatever, I actually have to...
You're insane. How can you short sell on prefabs after these human colony attacks? They're going to see a ton of business.
How do I...
A ton of immediate charity business.
Oh, Gianna Perosini, what up, girl?
Shepard? The news said you were dead. What happened?
No, wait, probably classified. Forget I asked. You just have to lie.
I'm Gianna Perosini, Novaria Internal Affairs. You screwed over my corruption investigation of Administrator Analeas.
Oh yeah, I remember that. Heh, sucks to be you.
I was worried about bigger problems at the time. Saren was trying to destroy the galaxy.
No kidding. And using our labs for his experiments. Man, we caught some heat over that one. Anyway, I eventually got Analeas fired for screwing an Asari tax inspector, so it worked out. Have a seat. You can buy me a beer. What brings you to Ilium? You know, that you can talk about.
So, Analeas, the scumbag Solarian from Novarian, from Port Hanshan, Novaria Internal, from Novaria Port Hanshan, banged an Asari tax inspector when she came to inspect the taxing. And so then that was considered unethical, and so she got him fired. Nice.
Nothing I can talk about. No offense, but Novaria was dealing with the enemy last time.
Damn, you're a hard ass. I'd forgotten that. Hey, listen, I just remembered something. I've got to go. Talk to you later. And don't forget to drink your beer.
Shepard had to leave Target Sami, couldn't recover Asari merchant smuggling schematics from Novaria. Novaria, can you talk her into showing good stuff? Sure. I'll seduce her. For sure. First, I want to check this stuff out, though.
This should come in handy.
Welcome. You look like someone who needs high-quality equipment. Feel free to look around. My store has the best tech and biotic equipment on Ilium.
Stuff might be crap, though.
How do I know this stuff is any good? You're an Asari. Maybe your stuff is no good for humans.
I carry nothing but the best. I offer a money-back guarantee.
That doesn't help me when I'm dead due to equipment failure. Look, I'm dropping too many credits to screw around here.
Well, perhaps I could give you a preferred rate at the kiosk. Here, a small discount, and when I get special items in, you can take a look.
What kind of special items are we talking about?
Oh, you know, schematics, designs. Nothing illegal, but I may not have all the licenses to sell them.
Do you have anything else? Anything not listed on your main merchandise kiosk?
Well, there is one thing. Very advanced design. Not publicly available yet.
That's because it's still in development on Novaria, and illegal for export. Hello, Hermia.
Parasini! You set me up! But this isn't Novaria. You don't have the authority to arrest me.
I don't care whether you go to jail. I've got all the evidence I need to find you out of business.
Ooh! Ooh! Got him! What about the schematic, though? I want it.
Do you have the authority to seize the schematic she's trying to sell?
I don't have to. Hermia was under suspicion. We leaked a faulty device to her. All this thing will ever do is blow up in your face.
I need to go. I have to talk to my lawyer.
Talk fast, Hermia. When the fines hit, you won't be able to afford him.
What the heck? Her head is like all the way around her body. That's so freaking weird.
I've got to file a few papers. Come by my table when you've got a minute.
Okay.
Hermia is going to be a very poor woman very shortly. Thanks for the help, Shepard. I love nailing Asari. So ageless and superior. Then you get them and they squeal like schoolgirls.
So do I actually get to talk to you this time? Or do I need to help you do your job again?
Hey, come on, Shepard. Wasn't it at least a little fun? I do the groundwork, you swoop in and get the mark talking. Hell, at least this time I didn't have to wear heels and a dress.
That's true.
How'd you end up on Novaria, anyway?
Scholarship program and a competitive internship. Turned out I was only middling at the science, but I could always ferret out secrets. You grow up poor and surrounded by rich kids, you get good at hiding yourself. Helps with going undercover.
What's up next for you?
Research. We've had some hacking attacks lately, and I want to make sure they're external. A lot of people are suddenly interested in dark energy. My bosses want to know if it's something to worry about. That'll hold me over until I have to go back undercover anyway.
It must be hard, going undercover so often.
It's not so bad. Go new places, be new people. The only weird part is when you go home and try to talk to people, and you forget how to react. Like it's another cover, you know?
Deep down, part of you likes fooling people. That's what makes you good at it.
Part of me, yeah. I grew up poor and working class. Now I walk around the rich and powerful, taking notes, getting evidence. And they never see me coming.
Hmm.
It's been a pleasure, Gianna.
You too, Shepard. See you around.
See you later, Gianna. It was good seeing her, though. It's been a while. I've been dead for a while, so, you know.
Oh. I need minimal heat increase. And speed. I have extremely high performance requirements.
Oh, cool. I received the bypass module from her. Cool. Wait, no, that was from when I bought it. Okay, never mind.
Hello, Commander Shepard. Liara will be pleased to see you.
What's Liara's reputation here on Ilium?
She is greatly respected. In a few short years, she's amassed a sizable network of connections. She could have even more political power than she already wields if she weren't so focused on her personal goals. But I believe she should tell you about that, not me.
You're Liara's assistant?
Yes. Liara relies upon me to acquire useful intelligence. I don't have her network of contacts, but I supply her with supplemental data. It's really an honor to work with her.
That sounds super sarcastic.
Of course, Commander.
Of course, Commander. Like, oh man.
Have you faced an Asari commando unit before? Few humans have.
Liara.
I'll make it simple. Either you pay me, or I flay you alive. With my mind. Shepard! Nyxeris, hold my calls. Shepard.
Liara.
So good to see you. How you doing, girl?
My sources said you were alive, but I never believed. It's very good to see you.
You're making some serious threats, though.
You're threatening to flay people alive now?
Oh, that. That was just a customer unhappy with the information he received. He'll pay. They always do. Ever since I helped you stop Saren, people have wanted to be my friend, or not be my enemy. I've set up a respectable business as an information broker. It's paid the bills since you... Well, for the past 2 years. And now you're back, gunning for the collectors with Cerberus.
That's not exactly public knowledge.
Neither is you being alive, Shepard. Information is my business now. And if you need information on finding people, I'm happy to help.
What about you, Liara? I could use your help on this mission.
I can't, Shepard. I'm sorry. I have commitments here, things I need to take care of.
What kind of things do you need to take care of? Are you in trouble?
No, no trouble. But it's been a long 2 years. I had things to do while you were gone. I have debts to repay. Listen, if you want to help, I need someone with hacking expertise, someone I can trust. If you could disable security at key points around Ilium, you could get me information I need. That would help me a great deal.
What's this all about, Liara? Can't you just talk to me?
Don't you think I want to, Shepard? This isn't because I don't trust you. This is Ilium. Anything I say is probably being recorded.
Hacking a terminal sounds pretty easy. Why do you need me?
I don't know anyone else I can trust. Hacking the security node won't get you the data. It just creates a minor glitch in the system. You'll have a short time to find a local server left vulnerable by that glitch, and upload the data to my system. I'm leaving my own system vulnerable so that the data can be imported during that short time.
If it'll help you, I'll take care of it.
When you hack one, a server will open somewhere nearby for a short time. You can download data from there, if you hurry. Thank you, Shepard. This may help me pay a great debt.
There's an Asari named Samara here on Ilium. You know where I could find her?
Samara. Yes. She arrived recently and registered with Tracking Officer Dara. You can find Dara at the transportation hub.
Why would Samara have to register with a tracking officer? Is she a criminal?
No. In fact, she's quite the opposite. Samara is a Justicar, one of an ancient sect of Asari warriors. Dara can tell you more.
I'm looking for Thane Krios. He's supposed to be here on Ilium.
The assassin? Yes. He arrived here a few days ago. My sources tell me he may be targeting a corporate executive, Nissana Dantius. He contacted a woman named Serena. Serena has an office in the cargo transfer levels. Perhaps she can tell you where Krios is.
That was all just off the top of your head?
I'm a very good information broker, Shepard. The world of intrigue isn't that different from a dig site. Except that the dead bodies still smell.
Thanks for the help. That's all I needed to know.
Of course. If there's anything else I can help you with, let me know.
I'll talk to you later, Liara.
I'm gonna do Lair of the Shadow Broker later. I'm gonna focus on getting my team first, and then once I have my team, not necessarily all of them loyal, but once I at least have my whole team, then I'll do the Shadow Broker DLC with Liara. Let's go to Eternity.
Do you have anything flashier? I want something that says, I own this room.
Come to Genetic Services.
We'll figure. It's okay, I'll think of something.
You said Synthetic Insights would buy me. You said it was an easy sale.
I assumed they would want an AI tech. Hello, can I help you with something?
Have you made this Quarian your slave?
We prefer the term indentured servants. Before you do anything hasty, know that this Quarian signed the agreement voluntarily, and her servitude contract is completely legal on Ilium. If you actually want to help the Quarian, convince the Synthetic Insights representative to purchase her contract.
What if I bought her myself? I could let her go and everyone would be happy.
A gallant offer with three problems. First, her technical skill merits a contract of several hundred thousand credits.
There is also a fee for freeing me before my service period ends.
Exactly. And finally, you are clearly a traveler. Her service contract requires that she remain on Ilium.
I don't want them to take me off to a mine somewhere.
Why did this Quarian sign herself into slavery?
I tried to play the stock market. I'm good with numbers, and I thought I had a way to make unlimited money. I lost everything. Then I got a credit line and lost that. Then I took out an illegal loan. You get the picture.
As part of our agreement, I paid off her debts. 5 years from now, she'll have a fresh start and excellent work references.
Huh, cool.
Sounds great. Unless you lose her paperwork or come up with a reason to hold her longer.
All contracts are monitored by Ilium Law Enforcement. In a case such as you described, the burden of proof would be on me. No system is perfect, but safeguards are set up to protect all parties.
If slavery is legal, then why are you trying to sell the quarry?
I don't keep service contracts myself. I'm a contract broker. I assumed Synthetic Insights would jump at the chance for a skilled AI tech, but they won't even make me an offer.
Sorry, I'm trying to... There's like a little something on my pop filter. I was trying to get it off. Okay.
Why not just keep her? You said she had technical skills.
Quarian's strict health requirements and diets make them expensive to house and feed. I run at a minor profit at best. I don't have the money for constant suit repairs and clean room facilities.
So what happens if Synthetic Insights won't take me?
A solution always presents itself. I will take care of you.
So slavery is legal on Ilium?
Indentured servitude lasts a set amount of time or until agreed upon conditions are met. Ilium must approve all contracts. The law limits what restraint or corrective options I can use and what tasks I can legally assign her. I'm also legally responsible for her behavior and health. Abuse is absolutely forbidden.
Huh.
I'll talk to the Synthetic Insights rep and see what I can do.
Really? Thank you. I'd appreciate that.
So then he says, oh, it's okay. Our amino acids are all different, so it's not like we can get diseases or anything if we go natural.
I'm telling you, this is why you shouldn't date humans.
So then I had to explain about cross-species fluid contact. Completely killed the mood.
Not to mention that you're a Quarian. How could he be so insensitive?
Can I help you with something?
How would you like to get your hands on an expert Quarian AI programmer?
If you'd like to submit a resume, I... Wait. Is this that slave? Synthetic Insights has no interest in purchasing slave labor. We're under enough scrutiny from the Citadel without engaging in practices the Council disapproves of. To be frank, we're hardly hiring anyone. The Geth attack on the Citadel didn't engender much love for artificial intelligence.
I see what's going on here. This isn't about slaves. You just don't want to hire a quarry.
What? But...
I'd hate to see the migrant fleet park the entire flotilla in orbit over your headquarters to protest your racism.
Huh.
Synthetic Insights has a strict non-discrimination policy. We don't just hire indentured servants.
Maybe I'll take this to Ilium's Trade Bureau, just to be sure.
Wait! Let's not do anything crazy. We don't want to waste the Bureau's time. Okay? Fine. I'll go draw up a contract. Just leave Ilium's bureaucracy out of it. This Quarian had better be good, though.
Awesome. Hello, bartender.
Welcome to Eternity. I'm Athida, sorry, matriarch and bartender. What can I get you?
I'd like something to drink.
Sure. I'll set up a tab at the drink kiosk. Knock yourself out. Literally, if you want. Just don't drink anything for Turians or Quarians. Does nasty things to your insides. Once saw Krogan drink a liquefied Turian on a dare 6 or 7 centuries back. Nobody came out of that one looking pretty.
How old are you exactly?
Exactly? Hell if I know. What year is it? I am a matriarch, though, if that's what you're wondering. Most matriarchs head back to Thessia, our homeworld, so everyone can listen to their wise counsel. I serve drinks. Dad was a Krogan who fought in the Rachni Wars. My mother fought in the Krogan Rebellions. I've pretty much seen it all.
If your mother fought in the Rebellions and your father was a Krogan, didn't that cause tension?
They didn't meet until a few hundred years after the Turians put the boot in with the damn Genophage. As far as either one knew, they were both just warriors. Dad boasted. Mom stayed quiet. Mom was a matriarch herself. Dad was near on 1,000 when the truth came out.
What happened when he found out?
I was about 100, shaking my ass in some sleazy bar. They got me on the link. Told me that they were gonna have it out. And made me promise to love whichever one survived. Turned out to be damn easy, since neither one did. Family, huh?
The heck?
What a kick in the quad.
What the heck? That's so weird. What the heck?
Your mother fought in the Krogan Rebellions?
I don't know whether she fought. She scouted, sniped a few people, and blew up a couple of space stations. You know, commando stuff. She'd put the old commando leathers on for special nights with Dad. Goddess, that was embarrassing.
You said your father fought in the Rachni Wars.
Yeah, when he was young. Loved showing off his war scars. Krogan think they're sexy. Me, I go for asses. When I was a girl, he'd tell me about landing on this poison-filled world and stomping Arachni Queen into muck. Scientists say all that stuff about us getting genetic material from the father is crap. Seems like I got a bit of his mouth, though.
Why is a matriarch in a bar serving drinks?
It's better than what most other matriarchs are doing. Look at that screw-up with Saren and his Geth a few years back. All that Asari wisdom got the Destiny Ascension blown to hell, and now you humans are in charge. And I warned him. Told people on Thessia what was coming, and they didn't want to hear it.
What didn't they want to hear?
That art and philosophy and political prowess wasn't gonna cut it. We can't go a single Asari lifetime without some big war breaking out. We need to get our daughters working earlier, not spending their wild maiden years stripping or in merc bands. When I started talking about making new mass relays ourselves, they laughed the blue off my ass. So now, I
That makes so much sense, though. Like, create your own mass relays. That's extremely smart, because then it opens up whole new parts of the galaxy that people don't have access to. And if anyone is skilled enough to do that, I mean, it would be the Asari. I mean, they've been a part of the they've discovered the mass relays first. They were the first species of this cycle that discovered the mass relays. With the technical expertise of the Quarians and the resources of the Turians and Asari combined, the three of them and the technical expertise of the Solarians, they could very easily make their own mass relays. Well, not easily, but you know what I mean. They could make their own mass relays. That's smart.
Thanks for telling me about that.
Right. Don't eat the nuts and the Red Bulls. They're for Turians and Quarians. You'll get cramps.
Okay. Ooh, liquor. And I'm in the table. I'm so drunk. Mystery drink. Let's drink that. Let's get, like, so drunk and just pass out. And a glass of wine. Get crazy drunk. Whoa, I'm so drunk. Whoa.
I still don't see why we're here. Solarians do not get married. My family simply negotiated a reproduction contract.
Whatever. It's the closest you guys get to a wedding. And that means you get a bachelor party. End of story.
Okay.
Synthetic Insights just sent over the contract. I cannot thank you enough.
I didn't do it for you. I did it for her.
Regardless, a kindness to her is mine to repay. Here, for your trouble. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'll get this service contract transferred.
Awesome.
Thank you. I'll stay out of trouble this time.
For sure. For sure. Now, let's go and make our way over to try and recruit Samara.
This is the best you have, I'll make do. But you're certain the neural simulators are compatible with both my speed and the scholarly physiology?
Hello, Solarian.
I know the data is vital to the Kurosa family. Asana Dantius didn't give us time to pass. I'm lucky I got out at all, for mercenaries were starting to shoot. If she lets us back in, I'll get it, I promise. If not, well, we'll just have to hope.
What's up here?
Alien News would like to offer a clarification of our special report on notorious assassin Thane Krios. While Alien News did credit Thane Krios' legendary.
Trust me, the goods coming in from the Terminus systems are great for business.
I don't know, some of them seem dangerous.
The store's over there.
You're sure gateway weapons and armor are good enough for Eclipse?
Yeah, buy all the things. Yeah.
Yeah, I've got a friend in it.
All blue rose of Ilium.
Ooh, a fish.
Let your roots dig deep into the hot soil of T'Chanka.
Yeah, let's buy a fish. Hello, Krogan. Sorry.
What do you want?
What do you want?
Sorry. That damn Krogan's love poems are getting on my nerves.
The Krogan is reading those love poems to get your attention.
His name is Char. We're kind of dating, but, well, we're on a break. And he's trying to show me how sensitive he is by, well, wooing me. It's really bad.
This is funny.
Why are the two of you on a break?
He's serious. Serious, as in talking about kids. Char is a great guy to date, but for something permanent... Krogans live long lives. It's not like dating a human where you just stick it out for a century till they die.
Wow. No, that's really racist.
Likes me. Or if he just wants kids, he can't have them any other way, you know. Because of the genophage.
Blue Rose of Ilium. You have blossomed in a
That's actually really racist. Just stick it out for a century until they die. It's like suffering. Jeez, that's pretty racist for me, sorry to say. Funny, but racist.
That sounds like a question you should ask him.
I did. I don't think he realized that our kids would always have been Asari. Non-Asari don't always get that we're not taking alien DNA. We're just using it to randomize some of the genetic information. Anyway, Char was quiet for a long time. Then he said that he'd love our girls no matter what color they were.
Aw, that's nice.
It doesn't seem common for Asari to date Krogan. What brought you two together?
He's a fun guy. Really smart. Especially for a Krogan. And he's got a good job as a transport technician. It's fun to join a mercenary guild or dance at bars for a few centuries, but eventually you hit the matron stage, you know? Then you get your back tattoo removed, let your scalp go back to its natural blue, and settle down with someone dependable.
You need to talk to your boyfriend. He's just gonna keep shouting poetry until you do.
I know, true enough. But it's tough. I like him a lot. Hell, I love him. But I don't know if he's permanent bond material.
Oh man, this is tough. I actually want her to get back together with him, but I also don't want to risk the Paragon points, because I'm Renegade. Gosh, this is actually kind of tough. I don't know what to choose, guys. I don't know what to do. I'm gonna hate myself for this.
Listen, he's a Krogan. Any talk about kids is gonna mess him up.
I know. You can't talk to Krogan about the genophage. They get so angry.
If you settle down with him, you'll spend the rest of your life wondering if he was after you or kids.
Yeah, you're right. I guess I needed to hear somebody else say it. I'm going to talk to him. Here, I've given you a discount at the terminal.
I'm gonna hate myself for saying that. I actually want them to be together now, but... I just destroyed a relationship for Renegade points. It better have been worth it.
What about you? Going to try and make it as a commando?
Why not? Every Asari has biotics. Might as well use them, right? Damn, that's a hell of a sniper rifle.
If you say so.
Alright, let's hack this crap. Crap, missed it. There we go.
It's just, we're looking for weapons. Shouldn't you be taking this seriously?
Hey, I'm 60 years old and finally
I'm telling you, relax. Vax will never notice a few missing pieces.
For example, you know that new drug, the one that causes permanent neural scarring?
No, she won't even talk to me. I don't know. She really has it in for humans. That might explain the damn contract. You're Shepard? I don't know if you remember me. I was a colonist at Zoo's Hope on Pharos.
Vanessa Marshall!
You saved us
from
an enormous Geth attack, and from the Thorian creature's control. Too many people died in the fighting for us to save the colony. It's still better than being a slave to the Thorian, though.
Where did the survivors go after Zoo's Hope shut down?
Most of us stayed together and went back to Earth. Run down, but familiar. We needed familiar faces. Exogeny pretty much left us alone. They just left with every bit of Thorian goop they could find.
Well. But yeah, the person who voices this character is Vanessa Marshall. She voiced Black Canary in Young Justice. She voiced Black Widow and a bunch of different like Marvel animated stuff. And she also currently voices Hera Syndulla in the Star Wars Rebels. Very awesome voice actress. Like her a lot.
I'm sorry. I've got other things to deal with.
Oh. Okay. But just don't sign anything. We're getting screwed over on a contract we signed with Baria Frontiers for some medical studies.
Well, I'm gonna go take care of that. First, hold on, I gotta do this thing.
You can sell something that dangerous with just a contract and a waiver?
These are the Terminus systems. Everything's dangerous, and everything's for sale. Either we tax and monitor it to keep some control, or the smugglers get a monopoly.
Is it this way? Yeah. There we go. Hello.
I saw your conversation, human. You're here to complain about the medical contracts those colonists from Pharaoh signed. I suggest you leave. Your life is short enough. Do not waste what time you have bothering me.
What's your problem with humans?
Not just humans, it's all of you. The Salarians and Turians are no better. The galaxy would be a better place if nobody but the Asari had ever dragged themselves out of the primordial muck.
Wow, racist.
Why are you so prejudiced against aliens?
Where do I begin? With Salarian explorers unleashing the Rachni upon us, then unleashing the Krogan to correct their mistake? Or the Turians, so eager to bomb every problem away? Or humans, the new arrivals who already think they should be in charge? Every war that has plagued this galaxy has been caused by your people. My people's deaths are on your hands.
Whose deaths are we talking about exactly?
The mother of my daughters was killed on the Quarian homeworld during the initial Geth uprising. My daughters died on the Citadel when the Geth attacked. One worked in the embassy. The other was a greeter for the consort. I'm not speaking in hypotheticals, human. The aliens will never be my allies. The best they can do is give me useful medical data.
Your bondmate was with the Quarians. Your daughters work with aliens every day at the embassy and the consort.
And look what happened to them!
You've suffered, I get that. But these colonists were trying to live peacefully. They've suffered too. They lost family to the Geth and the Thorian creature. Don't add to their anguish.
Yeah, like, really?
I'm sending an amended contract. No more tests, no fees. There's enough grief in this galaxy. I don't need to add to it.
Yeah, seriously, like, that's really selfish. Honestly. Other people in the galaxy were suffering, and so your maid and your daughters are trying to help them, help ease the suffering and help those innocent people who were suffering. Then there are more people who are suffering, and because of the deaths of your maid and your daughters, you're hating on them. That's just spitting on their memory. They lived their lives trying to help people who have suffered, and here you have people here you have people who have suffered, and you're making them suffer even more. In memory of the loved ones you've lost. That doesn't make sense. Alright.
Did you get the star charts?
Yeah. I had to deal with Arinia, though. I feel like I need a shower.
What do you expect? She's a pureblood. They're all like that.
She's a pureblood.
I just received the revised contracts. Thank you, Shepard. I don't know what we would have done without you.
Okay, bye. Let me talk to you, Officer Dara.
Can I help you with something?
I'm looking for an Asari warrior named Samara.
Wait, why? Do you have a problem, or did she kill somebody already?
I have no idea. Just tell me where she is.
If you insist, but fair warning, watch yourself around Samara. Justicars have a nasty habit of shooting people. She went to the commercial spaceport a few hours ago. If you want to get there, the pedestal on that balcony will summon a cab. Just be polite when you meet her. Justicars embody our highest laws, and they usually stay in Asari space. She's not used to dealing with aliens.
Is Samara really that dangerous?
If you follow the laws, you've got nothing to fear, and a Justicar would die without hesitation to protect the innocent. But their code orders them to stop lawbreakers, with lethal force in most cases, and everyone skirts the law somehow on Ilium. If someone tried to bribe her, she'd be obliged to gun them down as a matter of honor. I'm hoping to avoid that.
Hmm.
Why are you worried about other species coming into contact with her?
If a Justicar kills an Asari, none of us questions it. But if she killed a human, do you think the Alliance would understand her actions and respect her authority? You can't even figure out your own religions. It's a
Fair
big
enough.
Diplomatic incident just waiting to happen.
Hmm.
Tell me about the Justicars.
They're a monastic order. They've given up their families and possessions to follow their code. Most of them are on some lifelong mission, but they'll always stop to deal with any injustice they encounter, which can be a problem. In some ways, they're a lot like the Spectres, undertaking personal missions.
Spectres are authorized by the Council. Who do Justicars represent?
What? That's like, I don't know, a good human metaphor. They represent their code, our code. It's closer to a religious group than a legal branch. No law-abiding Asari would question a Justicar's orders. Nobody becomes a Justicar for personal gain. And they die before breaking their oaths.
Hmm. Alright. Yeah, let's go check it out.